get with this or you can get with that. Well, this one, although little known, may be poised to showcase and sparkle today in Lincoln. This or that? Well, that one is well known with skills tailor-made for Big Red success for the Huskers. Welcome to Memorial Stadium at Tom Osborne Field in Lincoln, Nebraska for ESPN College Football, presented by 5-Hour Energy. Nebraska looking to help the Big Ten bounce back from a rough weekend. Well, for the Sun Belt Conference, they had a huge upset last week. Gus Malzahn and Arkansas State would love to get another one this week. Back home in Arkansas in his first year at State, says he would love to turn this program into the Boise State of the South. They'll be squaring off against Bo Pelini and the Huskers, now in his fifth season for Bo. The previous four, at least 9 wins and a trip to a bowl game, looking to make amends for a rough weekend out in Los Angeles and the loss to UCLA last Saturday. Spectacular morning here. We're pre-noon for the kick. Local time, 66 degrees and sunny skies. Bo Pelini with the defensive background, Gus Malzahn with the offensive background. And Arkansas State not only wins the toss, but Gus wants the ball first, and they are set to receive. Kickoff from the 35, and Arkansas State will bring it out of the end zone. And they will get their first hands on it about the 23-yard line on the return by Rocky Hayes. Well, Ryan Applin will be in at quarterback, the Sun Belt Conference Player of the Year and Student Athlete of the Year. He needs just a couple of touchdown passes to become the school's career leader. This is an up-tempo offense. 98 plays they ran last week, racked up over 600 yards of total offense in a win over Memphis, a team that will be moving to the Big East next year. And all eyes here in Lincoln on the Nebraska defense, looking to see if they have improved over last week. And trying to get out to the edge. Well, the first carry and cut down quickly was Hayes. Let's take a look at today's impact players, brought to you by Longhorn Steakhouse.
But for Arkansas State, we got David Okluh averaging 105 yards a game this season. Wide receiver Josh Jarboe, 7th in the country with 9.5 catches a game so far this early season.
And before Arkansas State could get that snap off, a stoppage in play. Officials getting together to discuss in the middle of the field. Bo Pelini was pointing to something out on the field and now calling the officials over to talk to them. The referee today, Mike Cannon. The umpire is Brian Neal.
Bo Pelini upset early in the game, Beth.
Timeout has been charged to Nebraska. And they had to call the timeout because they were getting personnel issues. You see the player trying to run on late. That is how fast Arkansas State will try and get to the line of scrimmage and snap the ball. And Applin on the play action, the pass out into the flat and across the 30 to the 32-yard line, a pickup of 4 yards. With the catch. That will set up a third down and a couple.
I think part of the reason to go fast offense is to confuse the defense and make it hard for them to get their subs on the field. So it's interesting it happened already in this game.
On the fake, Okluh coming out of the backfield. He's got the catch and the first down for Arkansas State. And Joey, what we're seeing, not only are they quick to the line, but they take their, they get out of the huddle. They don't want to show their hand too soon about where their personnel are going to be lined up.
Right, they run them right on the field and line them up, Beth. They don't come to the huddle, and the defensive coaches for Nebraska can't see who's coming on to get their subs in.
They had some tempo problems against UCLA, some confusion last week on the defensive side, and a big gainer out across the 45. And stumbling forward close to that first down again, they'll move the chains, Rocky Hayes.
Arkansas State couldn't ask for a better start to what they're doing. They want to start fast. That's two quick first downs. Look again, Beth. Nebraska's having trouble getting their subs out on the field. They're scrambled right now.
Ryan Applin very poised. That quarterback, they fake the pitch. Oku's going to keep trying to get to the edge. And the ball pops loose at the tail end of the play at midfield. Officials trying to unstack the pile. Oku hurtled over the top of a pair of defenders, and they will keep the football.
Oku leaves his feet, and as a running back, that is not what you want to do with the crowd coming. Just keep your head down, stay on the field, get the tough yards, and stay low, Beth.
Frankie Jackson now into the game in the backfield. This is an Arkansas State team that has already played a tough road game out at Oregon. They lost to the Ducks, but Gus Malzahn and the coaches think that that will help tremendously with their composure today. An incomplete pass looking for Julian Jones. Andrew Green had the coverage.
We can already see early Nebraska's playing more zone coverage. They got confused last week with the motion system of UCLA. This week going more zone coverage early because it's less confusing, a lot less switching by the defenders in the backfield.
Applin on third and eight. Has the man out along the sideline, and out of bounds is McKissick trying to haul it in. Andrew Green was right there to make sure he did not stay in bounds. The Nebraska defense under fire all week long because of how forgiving the black shirts were out at UCLA. The most yardage allowed in 56 years. And they are accustomed to having some of the best defenses in the country. And now on fourth down, just across midfield, the Red Wolves lining up as if they will go.
I think it's going to be a punt, Beth. I think this is going to be a quick punt. Oh, they are going.
Applin. Incomplete again, looking for McKissick on what looked like the same play, and Nebraska will take over at midfield. So the Nebraska defense able to hold on fourth down.
How about the gamble early? I mean, Arkansas State on the road, underdog, coming in here saying, look, we think we're as good as you are even on your home field. We're going to take a gamble on fourth down. It didn't work out. Now we'll see if Nebraska can capitalize on the short field.
I think they sense, too, that this could be a shootout today. It was Taylor Martinez under center now for Nebraska with outstanding field position. Amir Abdullah jumping out inside the 45-yard line. Abdullah getting the start today. Rex Burkhead will be unavailable with the MCL sprain, but for Taylor Martinez, his numbers on the season, now in his third year as the starter, just needs 39 yards on the ground to join Eric Crouch with over 2,000 yards rushing and 4,000 yards passing. Crouch, the former Heisman Trophy winner. The draw, Abdullah boxed up right at the 45-yard line. Amos Draper with the stop. How about the impact players for the Huskers?
For Nebraska, what Amir Abdullah, the running back, smaller guy, 185 pounds, that runs between the tackles. Spencer Long, the offensive lineman, best one on this team, will lead the power game for Nebraska. And Will Compton, the quarterback of the defense, gets everyone lined up.
Four wideouts for Nebraska on third down. Martinez has the first down yardage to Anunwa, stepping out of bounds at the 39-yard line. There is Rex Burkhead without the pads on today, injured in the season opener. Did not play against UCLA last year. He was 19th in the country in rushing. They hope to have him back next week. In his place, Abdullah, take rope down the sideline. and nudged out of bounds at the 31.
The power sweep to the left for Nebraska. Abdullah has gained 8 yards each time they've run that play early in this offense. Maybe they see something to the left side, to the right of the defense that they like over there.
They were running Abdullah late, deep guy in the eye. They'll get the three. Diving inside the 30, if he reaches the 29, he's got the first down. Nathan Harold, the middle linebacker, with the tackle. The Red Wolves expecting a lot today from their linebackers, Nathan Harold and Don Jones, number 5 in white, who they feel is probably the best pro prospect on the defensive unit.
Waiting for Jones to break out. Arkansas State coaches, you know, talked about his ability. He has all the tools to be a big-time player. They're waiting for him to step up and have that breakout game where he gets on, he takes his game to another level.
They're also looking for a stop here. That's how much they've got to go. The problem for the Red Wolves defense, Oregon scored a minute and 38 seconds into the season opener. And then last week, Memphis scored 2.5 minutes into the game. So they are looking for a stop on the opposition's first drive here today. And Nebraska has been able to move it thus far after good field position. The failed fourth down attempt from Arkansas State setting them up nicely. And now third and a smidge. Martinez going to keep and go right behind that big front line. Justin Jackson, Sunun Choi, Spencer Long leading the way.
It's a sign of that power run game. Nebraska offense likes to go downhill. Right there is just our power versus your power, and Nebraska won that battle.
Amani Cross is now in at tailback for Nebraska. Play action. They're going to the backfield as well. Jumping over the defender inside the 5-yard line. Deshaun Lee saved the touchdown. 26 yards on the pickup. First and goal, Huskers.
Watch Abdullah just slide right out of the backfield. No one picks him up. Confusion, they thought it was a run play, it was a pass. Really nice pass by Martinez on the money. These kind of plays come off of the run game, and as long as Nebraska can run the ball, they can set up these kind of plays. Easy completion for Martinez.
McDermott, the motion man, Abdullah the carry. Bang his way right up the middle to the goal line. The ball pops out, and it will be whistled dead inside the one.
Yeah, appears to be down. Those are the tough yards inside that Abdullah at 185 is going to have to get for this offense.
Three in formation behind Martinez. Abdullah, the last guy through. And he's into the end zone for the touchdown. Attempt the extra point. He handles all the kicking duties for the Huskers. And he is true. A fourth down stop for the Nebraska defense leads to the short yardage touchdown run for Amir Abdullah. 7-0 Nebraska. Gorgeous day here in Lincoln, Nebraska. And the Huskers scoring on their first possession. They lead Arkansas State 7-0, just over 5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Beth Mullins, along with former Ohio State great Joey Galloway, Lewis Johnson also with us today. And Well, the fans here in Lincoln were looking for a statement from the defense, and they got it right away with a fourth down stop that helped them score the touchdown.
I thought it was an interesting call by Gus Malzahn. He comes in, he's in Nebraska, and he goes for it on fourth down on his own 50-yard line. Huge thought for this Nebraska defense that struggled this season so far. They make a statement, give their offense short field to work with.
And you like the moxie of Gus. He wants to go for it, wants to get the offense out there, and then Nebraska had the response. The offense back out for Arkansas State, but first, Wendy Nix.
Beth, thank you. A Taco Bell studio update. Virginia Tech at Pitt on ESPNU. Here's Ray Graham, his first touchdown since October of last season, a 12-yard run. The Panthers have a 7-0 edge. And on ESPN, Wake Forest and Florida State scoreless. On ABC, the same, California and Ohio State. Beth?
Thank you, Wendy. A terrific day again of college football. And after they could not convert a fourth down at midfield in their first possession, Ryan Alpin and company back at it. And the swing pass hit for 9 yards to J.D. McKissick. Again, it's an Arkansas State offense going very up-tempo. Nebraska has already been forced to call a timeout, trying to get the right personnel into the game. They run in Zaire Anderson at one of the linebacker spots, trying to get some more speed into the game. And Alpin, the pass incomplete, dropped by Rocky Hayes coming out of the backfield.
Seen a lot of motion by Arkansas State so far. That was something that gave Nebraska problems. You can see they look a little confused today, and guys have been open.
Quickly trying to get the first down yardage on third and one. And Alpin with the keeper for the first down. Baker Steinkuhler had the stop.
More confusion by Nebraska, still trying to substitute, running guys in and out. It's going to be tough to do with this quick pace offense.
Oku and the end around. And first down yardage and more out across midfield. And another big pickup for Rocky Hayes, who is listed as a defensive back. So Gus Malzahn, the magician, going back to work. Rocky, four rushing attempts on the season coming in, but he's getting quality time here early. Alpin on the play fake, now going to tuck it and run inside the 40, tripped up by Steinkuhler. And he appears to have another first down with a 10-yard pickup. Gus Malzahn hired as the head coach at Arkansas State. Most significantly, his time with Auburn, winning the national championship with Cam Newton. And now Ryan Applin taking the snap on first down. McKissick to the 30.
I've been impressed with this start by Arkansas State. They went for it on fourth down and got stopped on the last series, but they've been able to move the ball and get positive yards in early downs, which is setting up the second and shorts, the third and shorts.
Okay. Patiently waiting for something to open up. Gets to the 27-yard line. First guy there was the middle linebacker, Will Compton, and P.J. Smith. Down for Puchas. Well, you know, he's had a long week after the loss to UCLA. Jonathan Franklin rushed for over 100. They'll go for it again here. And third and short. And a penalty flag out of the backfield. Franklin actually had over 200.
Ball start. Offense, number 60. 5-yard penalty, third down.
False start on Stephen Honga.
How about the meeting with Papuchas? He starts off the conversation with, we did nothing good last week versus UCLA. I mean, that's how bad defensively this team was. UCLA was able to run the ball, were able to pass the ball, and they had communication
timeout.
Issues.
Arkansas State. That's their first timeout of the first half.
Arkansas State will use the timeout with a third down coming up. Back after this. Welcome back to Lincoln, 7-0, Nebraska on top. Down to the field now, Lewis Johnson.
Hey, Beth, thank you very much. Well, last week it was Nebraska losing to UCLA, and by their own admission, it was the Bruins' up-tempo style of offense that gave them a lot of problem. Well, guess what? We've already seen it. Arkansas State and Gus Malzahn are exactly that, up-tempo, and they're going to bring it today with that dynamic quarterback. But if you go back to week one of the season, it was Arkansas State that got hit in the mouth early and often by Oregon in that big loss. The Red Wolves offensive coordinator said it was a tsunami they could not weather. So be sure that Nebraska will continue to try to hit them. They've already got seven on the board. And Beth, it's really going to be about each team trying to exploit the other's Achilles heel today.
Well, Lewis, they'd love to keep their defense on the sideline right here on third down. Freddie Knighton to the air, and it's picked off. The interception by P.J. Smith. Gus Malzahn tried to sneak in one of the backup quarterbacks to make the throw, and it's picked.
And the play was actually open, and you expect to see these kind of plays out of Gus Malzahn's system. The play's open, but P.J. Smith sees the receiver out wide and recovers and makes a great play. Another big stop for this Nebraska defense.
Ben Papucha certainly happy about that. A fourth down stop and a turnover. The first two times the Red Wolves have had the ball. And now Taylor Martinez from his own 16, Abdullah. The touchdown earlier in the quarter. Nathan Harold with the tackle after the short gain up the middle. Abdullah will stay in, deep back in the eye. No Rex Burkhead available today for Nebraska. Martinez on the rollout. Down outside the 20-yard line. The Nebraska sideline wanted a horse collar flag. They will not get one. Don Jones coming up to make the tackle.
There's Don Jones, and we talked about his ability and his speed, and there's a play where he shows up. Martinez, the most dynamic playmaker for Nebraska. Don Jones makes an open field tackle and brings him down.
The crowd just reacted to the replay on the Jumbotron, which you folks at home saw. Definitely got the horse collar. Third and two. Martinez on the quarterback draw. He will not get it. Stuffed at the 25-yard line.
Sometimes on short yardage runs, the runner gets impatient. He needed to follow Long, who pulled around and looked as if there was a hole one player wider to his left. Martinez, when you need those short yardage gains, at times you say, I don't want to take a chance. Let me just go straight line and get straight ahead. Big stop for Arkansas State's defense.
We respond with the stop after the turnover. Going to kick it away. Rocky Hayes backpedaling all the way inside his 20. Makes the fair catch there. 57 yards on the punt. Ryan Applin getting set to go back to work.
ESPN College Football is presented by 5-Hour Energy. Hours and hours of energy. And in part by Mazda. We believe if it's not worth driving, it's not worth building. And Quikrete. Visit Quikrete.com. Quikrete, it's what America's made of.
Coliseum, home of the vaunted Nebraska women's volleyball program with the three national championship banners and one of the best histories in all of college volleyball. They're number one in the country, undefeated. They're at Iowa State today on the road with the Coliseum, one of the best places to watch some volleyball. And on first down, Frankie Jackson. Ball pops loose. And Nebraska has its second turnover of this first quarter. Damian Stafford recovering the fumble.
If you're Nebraska, you could not have asked for a better start. Defensively, Coach Papuchis said they need to communicate better. They need to stop the run better. They need to be able to get their playmakers out wide, which is why they're going a little more zone today versus man, so they can get their run fits in order. They look pretty good so far.
Well, they did not fare well in the first quarter at Oregon to start out the season. And the coach has talked about not getting overwhelmed by the atmosphere. We've got to come in and play with some composure. And an interception and a fumble early. We're going to review to see if the knee was down first. That knee is down there in the shadows. Where did the ball come out?
From that angle, it appeared that the knee was down, but it was hard to tell where the ball was at the time. So maybe they have a different angle than we have.
I mean, unexpected if you're Gus Malzahn coming in. You know we've got some questions about our defense, but offensively, that's our strength, and we can't help the opposition by giving it away on offense, which they've done at least once, possibly twice. Looks like the knee is down, and the ball is in Frankie's hand still. The official review going on upstairs. Appears that that is going to stay with the Red Wolves and get overturned. And that's what they've just gotten word down on the field, because the offensive unit's getting ready to head back out prior to official word from the referee.
Biggest play of the game so far, down 7 points already. The offense has been able to move the ball, but not been able to find points, get points on the board. It is important. And one of their goals, when you talk to Coach Malzahn, was to stay in the game, be in the game at halftime. You cannot allow Nebraska to get away from you. A turnover here would definitely damage their chances. They need to move the ball, change field position, and try to get some points.
I think they're trying to figure out where to spot the ball, where exactly the knee was down. Ready.
Well, I guess that makes the call.
The referee's microphone not working properly. But the play will be reversed, and the ball will go back to Arkansas State, and they are spotting it down at the 25-yard line. Let's check in with Wendy.
Beth, thank you. Oklahoma State looking to bounce back after that 21-point loss last week to Arizona. Cost the Cowboys a spot in the top 25. This will help J.W. Walsh to Kai Staley, who does the bulk of the work all the way to the end zone. Cowboys leading Louisiana Lafayette 10-0. Meanwhile, Illinois beating Charleston Southern 13-0, and Purdue over Eastern Michigan by a touchdown. Beth?
Thank you, Wendy. Well, that's good news thus far for the Big Ten after they went 6-6 last weekend as a league. And Louisiana Lafayette, that's another Sun Belt team like the one we're seeing here with Arkansas State. 9 of the 10 teams in the league are playing BCS schools today, 8 of them on the road like the Red Wolves. And now second down from the 25 after they get the ball back. And Akron will keep and get the first down. Getting out of bounds at the 34-yard line and a 9-yard run.
We don't talk a lot about Applin, his ability to run the football. He led this team in rushing last season, so he can run the ball. He's not going to go 92 yards like Martinez, but he will get you a first down. He's already rushed 3 times for 22 yards today.
Offensive coordinator Rhett Lashley says he often saves us the negative plays and turns them into positive ones. He will hang on as well here. Brought down by John Ankra. Well, Ryan Applin and some of the numbers, very impressive. Third active in total yardage behind Landry Jones and Matt Barkley. If he can muster a couple of touchdown passes, he'll take over the top spot in Arkansas State history. 4 years starting. So many guys are back. for Arkansas State. And in the backfield, Luke Compton able to bottle him up. And a loss of two on the play. But this is a team that won the Sun Belt last year. They had a 10-3 season. They went to a bowl. And they come in confident that they can make some noise here today. Facing a third and seven. To the air, incomplete, the flag down, intended for Josh Jarboe, and he was wearing Andrew Green, the defensive back. Going to be defensive pass interference against Green. That'll move the sticks.
Jarboe just comes straight upfield. It's a bump and run coverage, and at times defensive backs get themselves in bad body positions when they're playing bump and run coverage, and they tend to hold. Once a receiver stops, they can't see the ball, and it makes them reach out and grab the receiver.
Jackson, he'll get across midfield and into Nebraska territory. What is the challenge in that matchup, Joe, the wide receiver and the cornerback in this type of hurry-up offense?
Well, I think the cornerback has just got to focus on the receiver and play his hands. You're not going to get many interceptions when you're playing bump-and-run coverage from cornerback, so you just got to play his hands when the ball comes.
Looking down after taking the handoff of Jackson, P.J. Smith was there. An adjustment for the Nebraska defense. Lewis Johnson has more.
Yeah, Beth, the Nebraska defense had some communication issues against UCLA last week. You guys talked about it. So their defensive coordinator, John Papuchis, has introduced the wristband. You see them there. They're wearing them this week. He said he thought about using them last week but decided that doing it on the road was not a good deal. They've got about 25 defenses there hoping to help them deal with this up-tempo offense by Arkansas State.
Let's see how they do on third down, and they bring the pressure. That was another thing Papuchis wanted to do. Make Applin get rid of the ball quickly, and Ryan Applin appeared to be hurt on the end of that play. Good pressure from Eric Martin, and Applin holding the right arm as he heads to the sideline.
Eric Martin just comes off the end and beats the tackle. If you can get there, if you can get pressure with your front four guys defensively, you can play pretty good coverage, get shots on Applin, and keep that in his mind. He's got to pay attention to where these defensive ends are from Nebraska.
Applin hit the turf hard. He's getting some attention on the sideline. On fourth down, the punting unit on. Amir Abdullah calling for the fair catch. It will land well in front of him and take a Red Wolf bounce inside the 15-yard line. 39 yards on the punt. Boy, and a big game coming up tonight for Notre Dame and Michigan State, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC. Everett Golson and the Fighting Irish trying to get to 3-0. It's been a while, I think 2005, since they have beaten a top 10 opponent. Michigan State trying to stay perfect on the year as well.
Michigan State has not given up an offensive touchdown this season. You knew their defense would be good, and they've been very good so far.
Let's see again, Applin. Well, he landed elbow first on the turf.
Luckily, his left elbow, not the throwing elbow. And I stand corrected, it was his right elbow.
He's got some time to try and come back. An illegal formation penalty against Arkansas State will force them to re-kick it here on fourth down. And this time, Abdullah is going to give it a go. Amir Abdullah across the 25, 30-yard line, and out to the 33. Let's check in with Wendy Nix.
Beth, thank you. We check in Columbus, Ohio State's Braxton Miller. How about this 55-yard touchdown run on ABC? His fifth rushing touchdown that leads all FBS quarterbacks. And the Buckeyes are on the board. Missed the extra point, though, so it's 6-0. But the Bears have an answer, and it comes courtesy of Zach Maynard to Chris Harper. They will make the extra point, and it's a 7-6 ball game on ABC in Columbus.
Thank you, Wendy. Well, as much as Ohio State wants to downplay Braxton Miller, Player of the Year honors, he has off to another terrific start today. The quarterback for the Buckeyes. Merlin Hurd going to take the pitch. He'll try and sweep it to the left. And he will get to the 32-yard line, going to drop a couple. Nathan Harold and Don Jones, the linebackers we talked about getting there first, as we see the legends and leaders. Michigan State has the conference's lone ranked win. They beat Boise State. Northwestern has the only two wins against Power Six conference opponents. Victories over Syracuse and Vanderbilt. So the league trying to bounce back here in week three. The Huskers, one of those teams that got upset a week ago. Coming out of the flat is third, and again hauled down for no gain. Don Jones, and we're getting a look at the player that is the most athletic on this Arkansas State defense.
Early on, Don Jones has had a pretty good defensive day. He has showed up on both sides of the field. He's been their force so far. That's what they need him to do, to be the big play guy defensively for him.
Well, Nebraska, 2 for 3 today on third down. They were just 1 for 11 last week against UCLA. Martinez deep down the middle has the first down in the Red Wolf territory. Kyle Reed, the senior from Shawnee, Kansas, hauls it in.
This is the part of Martinez's game that they wanted to improve. He stood in the pocket, still with the sidearm motion, but puts it on the money, gets a completion. His feet looked good that time, Beth.
22 yards on the pickup. They've been working on getting Martinez deeper into the pocket so it's easier for him to read the defense and allow plays to develop. And here he reads the keep, pushed out of bounds at the 43-yard line. Last year, they didn't think he was dropping back deep enough.
And here's the pocket, and you can see the distance he has between himself and his offensive lineman. Gives him a chance to see over top of him and gives him a chance to see the receiver and complete the ball without guys in his face.
At 6'1", they thought that last year Taylor was struggling to see the passing lanes, and there he is deeper again in the pocket, going for 6, and he's got it! What a terrific touchdown pass for Kenny Bell! The extra point, 14-0, Nebraska with the 2-touchdown lead here in the first quarter. Martinez getting deeper, seeing deep downfield, and delivering on the money to Kenny Bell for 6 more. Kenny Bell with the 42-yard touchdown catch and a 14-0 lead for Nebraska over Arkansas State. Taylor Martinez off to a good start for the Husker offense. Their defense has forced a turnover and made a fourth down stop. 30 seconds to go in the first quarter, and the good news for the Arkansas State faithful, it does look like Ryan Applin will be able to return after this kickoff. Now to boot it away. Coming out of his own end zone, Frankie Jackson to the 27-yard line. Let's check in with Lewis.
Beth, Ryan Applin came over favoring that right shoulder, and the trainers took a quick look at it. They had him stick the arm out, kind of did those diagnostic testing. And then I noticed they left him alone. He got up finally, began to make some throws, and he shook his head yes when they were asking if he could go back in the game. But Joey and Beth, you know, sometimes if there is a problem, maybe it's minor, it's better to leave an athlete alone and let them play, especially in the throes of a big game like this. If it's a minor problem, you deal with it later, but right now they want him back out on the field, and that's where he is.
Gus Malzahn told us that his toughness is one of his best intangibles. And he's showing that right now. The receiver screen out into the flat and across the 30-yard line. Josh Jarboe, averaging 9 catches a game, 7th best in the country. That's his first of the day. Mo Cisse with the tackle, getting his first defensive action of the season in the Nebraska secondary, has played on special teams thus far. And that will take care of the first quarter here in Lincoln. The Nebraska Huskers leading Arkansas State 14-0. It's always a big game when the Huskers are at home. Even the guys up in the crane, one of the best seeds above the house here at Memorial.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
14-0 Nebraska as we get set to start the second quarter. You see the construction going on the east side of the stadium. They're adding some luxury suites, 6,000 additional seats, so it'll be up over 90,000. As J.D. McKissick has the first down out across the 45 for Arkansas State. You know what they say here, when there's a home game, Memorial Stadium becomes the second biggest city in the state behind Omaha. Over 85,000 in attendance again today, the 320th consecutive sellout dating back to 1962. And the up-tempo offense for the Red Wolves on display, moving it hastily. Ryan Applin, who was injured earlier, coming back to play at quarterback. David Okoo shuffles his way across the inside the 40, excuse me.
I think Arkansas State may argue that some of this red may be from their side. They got a few people sprinkled into this 85,000 crowd we're here today seeing.
I'm sure there's some Red Wolf faithful here. It's high times for Arkansas State out of Jonesboro, Arkansas. They set a new home attendance record last season as well, as the Sun Belt Conference champions, an injured Husker down on the field. This Sun Belt, the same league that Louisiana Monroe hails from, the team that upset Arkansas last week, trying to upset Auburn today. Thad Randall getting to his feet. Let's get an update from Wendy Nix.
Beth, thank you. Florida State with his first real test of the season. The number 5 Seminoles facing 2-0 Wake Forest on ESPN. And how about this, the punt return from Rashad Green all the way, and number 5 Florida State leading the Demon Deacons 14-0.
Thank you, Wendy. Randall able to get to the sideline. Kevin Williams, the redshirt freshman, is the backup. Last week, Louisiana Monroe with that huge win. They were picked to finish in the middle of the pack in the Sun Belt. So perhaps the lead stronger than given credit for nationally. Applin to the air, and he's got his man inside the 20-yard line. Carlos McCants, his first catch and a first down. Two-yard game. Quickly back to the line. Nebraska hustling to get a substitute in. An extra defensive back. Inside the 15 for the short game. Both Jackson, Steinkuhler, and Ankara were there.
Applin's arm is a lot better than expected, Beth. Watch this throw. Watch the throwing motion. He looks downfield, great feet, right over the top, and puts the ball on the money with the receiver with 1 yard to go to get out of bounds, 20 yards downfield. That is a heck of a throw.
Look at again, Nebraska scrambling to get a different defender onto the field before the snap. They do. Trying to communicate to David Santos what the alignment is. And now Arkansas State will have to call the timeout. It's
timeout.
Second of this first
Arkansas
half.
State. That's their second charge timeout of the half.
An extended drive for the Red Wolves. Can they get some points on the board? watching College Football on ESPN, presented by 5-Hour Energy. 14-0, the lead for Nebraska. Four undefeated teams highlighting ESPN's primetime doubleheader tonight. It's Florida, Tennessee at 6, Texas Ole Miss at 9:15. Tonight on ESPN and also on the Watch ESPN app. On second down, the eighth play of the drive that started on their own 27-yard line for Ryan Applin. Slings it for the end zone, incomplete. Intended for McCants, Andrew Green had the coverage.
And Applin takes another hit, and that's important for Nebraska's defense to hit Applin as much as you possibly can. Make him get up off the ground. Make him wonder where the pressure is coming from. That's another hit. Those are going to be key as this game wears on.
Third down and 8. Applin incomplete. Overthrows Josh Jarboe. Husker fans bringing a little more noise. So Applin started out 3-for-3 on that drive. And a couple of incompletions will get the field goal kicker on. Brian Davis, 4-for-6 on the season with a long of 43. This one will be a 31-yard attempt. And he's got it. Arkansas State puts up the 3 spot. A couple minutes gone here in the second quarter.
Coach Papuchis and this Nebraska defense wants to send pressure. They sent both linebackers up the middle of this defense, and that's where you wonder, when you hit Applin, does he have it in his mind, pressure is coming, I got to get the ball out of my hands. Threw the ball high, got it out quickly, which he's known to do, but he has got to complete that pass if this offense is going to keep them in the game.
And this is the challenge for Ryan Applin and first-year head coach Gus Malzahn trying to move the tempo quickly. There is Gus in the background behind Ryan, who's checking to the sideline. Gus will give him a signal. One of the other assistants will give him a signal.
And they have to wait and see what the Nebraska defense is doing. They're watching the Nebraska defense, watching them line up to know which play they want to run out of that formation. Looked like some confusion, but the confusion started on the sideline. And Applin is waiting, and the entire offense is waiting. And then they have to call a timeout and come to the sideline and talk about it.
Malzahn, of course, known as an offensive mind. His offensive coordinator is Rhett Lashley, a guy who was a grad assistant at Auburn when Malzahn was there. And they are kind of co-coordinators when it comes to the play calling. From the goal line, Kenny Bell spinning out across the 25 to the 28-yard line for Nebraska. And let's go to Wendy Nix.
Beth, thank you. We go back to Columbus. Again, Ohio State hosting Cal on ABC. And Braxton Miller, so far so good. That 25-yard connection to Devin Smith, extra point is good. And it's 13-7 Ohio State, but more where that came from. The 2-yard connection to Jake Stoneburner, and it's 20-7 Ohio State over Cal on ABC. And on ESPNU, Pitt up big over Virginia Tech, leading 21-0 in the second quarter.
Thank you, Wendy. And the toss sweep of Gula out across the 30 to the 31. And it's become a common theme, Joey, in the Big Ten Conference. The dual threat quarterbacks like a Braxton Miller and a Denard Robinson, and here today, Taylor Martinez.
These guys are changing the way football is played in the Big Ten. When you look at Northwestern, Kane Coulter, you look at Braxton Miller, that's all you talk about is these guys' big playability with their feet ripping off these long runs.
Martinez operating out of the gun on second down. Taylor's going to keep it. He's out across the 40, the 45, the 50, and inside the 45-yard line. Martinez calling his own number for 27 yards. How about the dual threats? We'll start out with Braxton.
Denard Robinson, another guy that is dangerous. These are guys you would love to see them throw a pass, because when they take off running, they can break off the 92-yard runs. And then Taylor Martinez just showed us what he can do with his feet, ripping off another 15-yard run.
Some of the dual threats around the Big Ten Conference. Nebraska has one more non-con after today, and then they will jump into the Big Ten schedule with a bang as Abdullah gets shoved out of bounds. Which, by the way, they will see three more up-tempo offenses in Ohio State, Northwestern, and Michigan. But they will start out with Wisconsin and end that stretch of 5 weeks with a trip to Michigan State. So they really want to find out a lot more about where they stand this week and next before heading into that Wisconsin matchup. And Taylor Martinez has 40 yards of rushing today, and that will put him over 2,000 for his career. Gave it up at the last minute to the 35-yard line. Here's a look at that schedule, and things will start in earnest on ABC September 29th.
Wisconsin has struggled early in the season, so we'll see where they are. But the stretch between Ohio State, Northwestern, Michigan, and Michigan State, that is a tough gauntlet, probably as tough as it gets in the Big Ten Conference.
At least the good news from Bo Pelini's perspective is he does think that Rex Burkhead will be available to get some carries in next week against Idaho State to help them prep for the Big Ten. Martinez across the middle as Reed inside the 30, and a Nebraska first down. Second catch for Kyler Reed, but a penalty flag on the defensive side of the field.
An eligible receiver downfield. Offense, number 25. He was covered up. 5-yard penalty. Replay, third down.
Well, that ended up being Reed, who's the guy that caught the pass. 10:22 to go here in the first half. 14-3. Nebraska with the lead over Arkansas State. A fourth down stop and a turnover for the Blackshirts today. And the quarterback comparison, Applin and Taylor Martinez. Taylor has the 42-yard touchdown pass to Kenny Bell. He's also got 40 yards rushing on the ground. Martinez back to the air, has time, and finds a number. Shakes loose from a couple of guys and tripped up at the 25-yard line. A 17-yard gain.
Anon was the big physical receiver for Nebraska, gets downfield. It's tough to deal with his physicality because he's so big. He's 6'2", 215. These smaller corners are going to have trouble staying with him. Puts his hand up, big, strong guy, reach out, snatch the ball out the air. It's tough to stop those big guys with a smaller corner.
Kudos to the offensive line thus far as well. They are giving Martinez the time to find the open man. This time out of the iron formation, Martinez has been inside the 10. Nice cut across the middle and into the touchdown. Into the end zone for the second time today. Touchdown catch of the afternoon. The point for Bacher is good. 9:29 to go in the half. The Husker offense, three scores and a 21-3 lead. At home today against Arkansas State. Taylor Martinez engineering another scoring drive for Nebraska and a 21-3 lead. He's got a couple of touchdown passes today. Enjoying his 22nd birthday with perfection thus far through the air. He's 7 for 7 136 yards. He's got a 42-yard touchdown to Kenny Bell and a 25-yard strike to Kenny Bell. He's also got 40 yards rushing, joining Eric Crouch as the only two guys in the 4,000-yard passing, 2,000-yard rushing club here at Nebraska. Who sends the kickoff well into the end zone and out the back end. And to start at the 25-yard line for Arkansas State. How about Martinez on that last pass?
Beth, you wonder what he did in the offseason. Watch his feet. His feet will tell the story here. Gets back in his drop, plants his back foot, no hop, no hitch, gets the ball out of his hands, perfect rhythm. If he can do that, that's what I talked about. He could be the best quarterback in the Big Ten if he continues to improve his passing game, and he has looked terrific here today.
He went and worked with a quarterback coach over the summer. He spent some time at the Manning Passing Academy this summer. He's a quiet guy, doesn't say a lot to the press, but he is a hard worker and really wants to get better to help himself and his teammates. So now Ryan Ackman and Arkansas State on first down. Frankie Jackson with the short game.
Taylor Martinez takes a lot of heat in this area for his ability to throw the ball and lead this team. This kid works as hard as anyone. He's a student of the game. You can see the improvement in these first three games of the season.
Ackman spinning deeper into the pocket. He's got a man open. A big hit from Damian Stafford to jar it loose. Incomplete. And the coaching staff talked to us yesterday about Damian Stafford as the guy that is most capable of stepping forward to be the playmaker on the defensive side.
They believe in Stafford, and he is a big hit guy. And this is the kind of play that they need out of the secondary. The receiver's open, Stafford delivers it, and here comes Stafford, jars the ball loose. That's what they need defensively, show that speed and that hitting ability.
Senior out of Norco, California. Second on the team in tackles this year. Back to the end, McKissick taken down at the 37-yard line. Josh Mitchell goes low to make the tackle, and he stays down. Arkansas State did get the first down on the play. We have a moment. We'll remind you that the chase gets underway with the Geico 400 in Chicago. It's time for the NASCAR postseason. Best drivers in the sport going head-to-head for the championship. The chase for the NASCAR Sprint Cup starts with the Geico 400 at Chicago tomorrow at 1 o'clock on ESPN. And there are the five guys on top, 12 all competing.
Beth, you have nothing else to do on Sunday. You got to sit down and watch the race. The NASCAR race, when the chase starts, it will be as good as any NFL game you ever want to watch.
Is anybody going to catch Denny Hamlin? What do you think?
Yeah, it's wide open. It is wide open, Beth.
Johnson and Stewart right there. Definitely who led for quite a while over the summer. Hamlin, 41-yard line, another big hit by Stafford, taking down Oku.
You can see the defense, Stafford is starting to fly around, showing some emotion, getting these guys fired up. Defensively, you get a lead, it automatically gives you a little more confidence. You can let your hair down, let things fly.
Hoffman's going to keep. Driving off to the 47. Well, whether it's the wristbands that Lewis Johnson reported about earlier, whether it's a little confidence from a good week of practice, the indecision that we saw on tape last week against UCLA does not seem to be there here in the second quarter.
And that we saw early in this game, the first few drives, there was a lot of indecision. They look a lot more comfortable now.
That's allowing a guy like Stafford to play with a little more abandon. Third and a couple. Oku, he's got it into Husker territory. Stafford gets him around the ankles to take him down at the 44. Allen Wright with a nice block on the right side of that line. Five rushes for 19 yards today for Oku. And the Nebraska defense, this is what has concerned the locals the points per game and the yardage per game all increasing significantly over the course of the last 4 years.
And I think that's what brings the heat. I mean, when you think of Nebraska, you think of the black shirt defense. And it just hasn't been there. And they've got increasingly worse over the last 4 years. And that's why the heat has come. Because where is our defense? If anything else, we could play defense. Bo Pelini is a defensive coach, and their defense has not improved.
Not too long ago, with Ndamukong and Sue, they had the top-ranked defense in the country. To the 41-yard line, it's going to bring up a third down. Let's check in with Lewis.
Hey, Beth and Joey, I don't think many people understand this pressure cooker of media focus and fan expectation that the Nebraska coaches and players have here in Lincoln. You know, unlike some other big schools where they may have another major college football program close to them, look, Auburn just 160 miles away from Alabama, Stanford only 46 miles away from Cal Berkeley. Here in Nebraska, the Cornhuskers are it. I'll follow up in a minute.
Third and seven. Ackland under pressure, scrambles, and then is run out of bounds at the 46-yard line. Jason Ankra bringing the heat along with Cameron Meredith. And a loss of three on the play. Lewis?
Well, Bo Pelini told us that it's normal to see 30 or more members of the media after every practice and every game, TV, radio, writers, bloggers, even social media types, which brings up another discussion for later. But he said the new rules about using social media is something he's had to deal with. But they are under tremendous pressure 24/7 to deliver. Remember those five championships from years gone by? Folks are expecting that right now.
He's been at Oklahoma. He's been at LSU. In the pros, he was in Green Bay. And Bo Pelini says that this fan base is the most avid and rabid that he has come across. And a nice punt will bury the Huskers deep in their own territory off the foot of Neely Sullivan. 44 yards on the punt. They come in from near and far, all generations, to Memorial Stadium to check out their Cornhuskers. And it's another sellout crowd today. 320 in a row. And a flag on that punt.
Illegal formation. More than four guys in the backfield. 5-yard penalty. Replay fourth down.
Well, that hurts Arkansas State. Instead of having Nebraska deep in its own territory, they're going to have to reboot.
Another big mistake. That is a heck of a punt to down Nebraska within the 5-yard line and give them 95 yards to score. Now we're going to see if they can do it again. That could turn out to be a really big penalty.
Wilborn. He's the punter. Under a little more pressure this time. And a chance for Abdullah. Much better field position at the 25-yard line.
That's a 23-yard penalty. That is a 23-yard penalty that they cannot afford to have.
Bo Pelini bringing the passion and the intensity that Nebraska sideline.
And college football brought to you by Lexus, introducing a stunning work of technology, the entirely new Lexus ES. AT&T, the nation's largest 4G network. AT&T, rethink possible. And Energizer Ultimate Lithium, that's positive energy.
Well, not just construction at the football stadium, but also the new home for Nebraska basketball, located downtown in the Haymarket District here in Lincoln. Scheduled to open for the men's and women's basketball teams next year. And now back to the action, a 21-3 lead for Nebraska. 5.5 minutes to go in that first half, and a 9-yard pickup for Abdullah. I wanted to go back to that picture we saw at the tail end of that last play, and Bo Pelini getting the pulse checked over there on the Nebraska sideline. Just after Lewis Johnson had reported, you know, about the pressure cooker that is Nebraska football. Martinez seeing a couple blitzing linebackers. He's going to change things up.
Gula. And some room across the 40. And a first down, Nebraska. Pickup of 7.
Arkansas State looked like they wanted to send a crossdog blitz, which is send both middle linebackers up the middle of the offensive line. The checking by Martinez got him out of that blitz and allowed them to run the football.
Dua now 12 carries, 45 yards, and the 1 yard touchdown run in the first quarter. Here he is again, finding some room across midfield. Dua inside the 35 yard line, getting another start today, replacing the injured Rex Burkhead. And Soon-Hoon Choi was the guy that sprung him 26 yards.
The offensive line is the key in this power downhill running game of Nebraska. Arkansas State was worried about this. John Thompson told us, we've got to be able to deal with their power running game, and Nebraska's heating it up.
This time it's Brandon Hurd. Close to first down yardage.
Another big run between the tackles. The size and the strength of this offensive line is starting to show on this drive. This is an attitude drive. This is setting a tone on this drive for Nebraska's offense.
Starting middle linebacker Nathan Harrell just ran to the sideline with an injury. He is out right now for Arkansas State. Hurd trying to follow Choi again. Ryan Carruthers, the junior from Nashville, with the tackle.
Harold is the leader of this Arkansas State defense. He's their leading tackler. They need him on the field. Without him, it's going to be that much tougher for them to stop Nebraska.
And Nebraska so much better today on third downs. They're 4-5. Harold down on one knee, holding his arm on the Arkansas State sideline. Dula. Oh, missed tackle in the backfield, and he's got the first down. Nebraska now 4-for-5 on third down in this first half. A pickup of 6. Amos Draper had him and couldn't hold him.
This offensive line is really starting to exert themselves now. If you're an offensive lineman, you get in that huddle and you say, please run the ball. Let us dominate. Let us show what we do here at Nebraska. That's what they're doing on this drive. They're opening up holes in the middle between the tackles for Abdullah.
And here's the deep back in the line. And another give to Abdullah. May have gotten back to the line of scrimmage. Lee was there, and Tim Starson had him wrapped up.
It's unfortunate to see Harold go out with an injury. He has dealt with injuries his entire career, and finally this season they say he's healthy and he's ready to go. You know, he's leading his team so far in tackles in the first two games. They need him on the field, so hopefully it's something minor. Hopefully he'll be able to return.
Injuries, he is their leading tackler. We love all the intangibles that he brings, including that leadership to the defensive unit. Martinez to the air, to the runner inside the 10. And a missed tackle. And another. Still on his feet to the 2 yard line. First and goal, Huskers. 14 yards on the pickup. That's his third catch of the day.
Arkansas State has got the tackle better than this. Anunua's the big, strong receiver, but these guys have got to tackle him in the secondary. There's one missed tackle, 2 missed tackles, 3 missed tackles. And then that guy, 4 or 5, there are 6 guys that had a chance to make a play here, and it gets down to the 2 yard line. Arkansas State, they've got to find a way to flip the momentum because Nebraska's offense is warming up and they're getting into what they want to do.
Chance for Nebraska to bust it open before the half. Abdullah, good penetration coming right up the middle from Kashawn Lee, who has slid over into the middle now, replacing Harold in that linebacking core. Oh, it's turning into a good in there. Broken tackle into the end zone. His second touchdown of the day from 2 yards out. It was a story of broken tackles and missed tackles last week for Nebraska, and that was the tale of that drive right there for the Arkansas State defense.
Arkansas State has got to tackle better. Coming into this game, we already knew Nebraska had to work on their tackling last week, and now we see in this game, Arkansas State, their lack of tackling is really hurting them.
We had wondered about the strength and the speed and how much of an advantage that might be for Nebraska today. They have been winning on both counts. And they now have the 28-3 lead. Abdullah, a couple of rushing scores. Martinez, a couple through the air. The Huskers in control. Well, ESPN College Football is available anytime, anywhere on your computer or mobile device via WatchESPN.com and the Watch ESPN app. And one of the fountains here on campus, they've had drought-like conditions here in this area of the Midwest. Hoping that we'll see a little bit more rain throughout the fall. It's a beautiful day today. Nary a cloud in the sky. Temperatures in the mid-70s at a 28-3 lead. Some of the worst drought conditions that they've seen in these parts in over 15 years. And the corn crop affected. I was even reading the other day the popcorn industry will probably be affected down the road as well. Coming down to the closing seconds of the first half, let's check in with Wendy Nix.
Beth, thank you. Coming up on the Discover Card Halftime Report, the Seminoles in Tallahassee looking to avenge last season's loss to Wake Forest. It's Miller time in Columbus, Ohio. And Todd McShay and Robert Smith join me with our Saturday setup coming up at the half.
Looking forward to that, Wendy. 35 seconds to go here in the half. Can Arkansas State get something going? Setting up the screen. About across the 30-yard line, Julian Jones. That's his first catch. They have just the one timeout remaining as the clock runs under 20 seconds. Ryan Apple. Out of the pocket. Throws it out of bounds.
Arkansas State is going to have to find a way to get something going offensively and start putting points on the board. They've struggled early in games in the first two games, but they've gotten it going in the second, third, and fourth quarter. Today they've struggled also in the second quarter, but they're going to have to turn this around in the third and fourth if they want to get back in it.
Off the pump, they climb across the middle on the slant. Move the chains. And then the clock will wind down. And they will not get the snap off. Well, Arkansas State will take a timeout with them into the half, which won't do them a whole lot of good. Gus Malzahn thought that there should still have been some time left on the clock.
Not sure why you don't call a timeout. Just call your timeout. I mean, there's 5 seconds left. It's going to be the last play. What are you saving it for? Just call your timeout.
Let's check in now with Lewis.
All right, thanks so much, Beth. Well, first of all, we saw someone taking your pulse late in this half. Are you okay?
I'm okay. I'm fine. All right. Not feeling real good.
Okay. Now, you needed better execution, especially on defense. Talk about how they've played here in the first half.
Now, you know what? I think they've handled it's crazy as fast as they're going and the things that are happening, and they threw a lot at us. I thought our guys reacted well, and we're doing okay.
All right, and your offense is also playing very well. How about your quarterback with his new feet after all? Great summer of work.
Like what he's doing. He's been efficient, and I think we're executing well. We let a couple guys go up front. We couple missed assignments in the run game, but overall, I like what I'm seeing.
All right, Bo, thanks. And look, hope you
feel
better.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Beth?
Thank you very much, Lewis. Well, that Nebraska offense, 278 yards, well-balanced in the first half, and a 28-3 lead over Arkansas State. And now to Wendy Nix in the studio. Always be friends. fast as you can. Well, that's the intent of both these offenses, to get it and go. Nebraska with the better of Arkansas State through the first half of play. 28-3, the Huskers on top. As we get set to start the third quarter, Nebraska will have the ball to get things rolling. Beth Mullins along with Joey Galloway. Lewis Johnson is also with us. A couple of rushing touchdowns, a couple of Taylor Martinez touchdown passes in that first half for the offense.
If you're Nebraska, this half couldn't have gone any better for you. If you're Bo Pelini, you have got to be excited. Almost 300 yards in offense. Amir Abdullah almost has 100 yards rushing. Martinez, 8 for 8 passing. I mean, this is what you wanted to do if you're Nebraska.
And on our Dave and Buster's playbook, unfortunately for Arkansas State, it's been a first half of missed opportunities and missed tackles.
John Thompson, the defensive coordinator, was concerned with the power of Nebraska and concerned with their ability to slow them down. They've got to tackle better. Too many missed tackles in that first half led to too many points for Nebraska. Arkansas State's got to find a way to tackle better and get back in this game.
And it's going to be Gus Malzahn's defense that's going to have to try and come up with a stop and not allow Nebraska to get too far out in front. A miscue on special teams will set back the Huskers inside the 15-yard line. Let's send it down to Lewis Johnson.
All right, Beth, thanks so much. Well, you and Joey talked about all the missed tackles for Arkansas State, and that was my first question to Coach Malzahn as he came out. He said, how do you fix bad tackling mid-game? He says, number one, Nebraska is so great, they're so fast and very strong and difficult to deal with. But he said if you're not tackling well, you've got to get more guys to the ball to try and slow them down. Now, offensively, they hope to try and get a stop and then score the first time they have the ball to try and get back in this game. Quick update on Bo Pelini. Said he felt like maybe the flu. We'll have to see how things go for him.
Thank you very much, Lewis. And on first down, Amir Abdullah, the ball carrier. He'll pick up about 8. So we scoured the sideline for Bo Pelini, and we are still looking. He was not feeling well in the first half of play. On second and a couple, Martinez will work out of the gun. He's going to step to the side. A couple of touchdown passes to Kenny Bell in that first half. The longest, a 42-yarder, and Abdullah will pick up 1 as he stretches forward. It's going to be 3rd and short. Amir had 81 yards and a couple of touchdowns in that first half on the ground, and we cannot locate Bo Pelini over there on that Nebraska sideline. It appears that he has stayed in the locker room dealing with the flu-like symptoms today. Third and short, Martinez will go under center, and Abdullah will pick up the first down. Following that right side, Jackson Long and Searles, a pickup of 3.
And that's part of Nebraska's downhill running game. They pull 2 linemen, come around the corner. They knock out the Arkansas State defenders, and it's an easy 5 yards for a running back when they do that.
Martinez pulls it back out of Abdullah's belly, and incomplete, almost intercepted at the 40-yard line. Threw it behind Turner and almost into the awaiting arms of Kashawn Lee. Tim Beck, the offensive coordinator and quarterback coach, up in the press box. In his second season as the offensive coordinator after a promotion on the staff. We can report that Harold is back in at middle linebacker for Arkansas State. He got just a little bit of Abdullah on that carry. Nathan Harold, their leading tackler, who was out with an injury for a spell in that first half, a pickup of 7. Down yardage for Abdullah. We're still waiting on word officially about the status of Bo Pelini, who told us at halftime, told Lewis that he wasn't feeling quite well today.
Beth, well, first of all, we saw someone taking your pulse late in this half. Are you okay?
I'm okay. I'm fine. Not feeling real good.
Okay. Now, you needed better execution, especially on defense. Talk about how they've played here in the first half.
Now, you know what? I think they've handled it. It's crazy as fast as they're going and the things that are.
He went on to talk about his team's performance in the first half, but he reported to Lewis that he was not feeling well. And we do not see Bo Pelini right now on the sideline for Nebraska. The rest of the coaching staff taking over here in the second half for Nebraska. There's Ron Brown, the running backs coach, who has now donned a headset. Martinez takes a hit, delivers it. Abdullah's got it out of the backfield to the 33-yard line. Hauled down by Don Jones.
Nebraska had done a pretty good job, you know, throughout the first half of staying out of third and long. They said that was their problem when they played UCLA, the third and longs, and they ended up only getting one out of 11 third down conversions. Here's a third and long situation, the first one we've seen today, and their offense comes off the field.
Rocky Hayes is back deep. Brett Maher getting set to punt it away here on fourth down. Jason Hayes back inside the 10-yard line. They'll get a bit of a running start. And breaking some tackles out to the 30-yard line. As we continue on the Bo Pelini story, we will take you back to some footage we had in the first half with the medical staff over there, and check out taking a look at Bo Pelini and getting the pulse there on the left arm. And then that was Coach Pelini trotting towards the locker room at the end of that first half. And the report is that he was feeling under the weather, just hit this morning. Nebraska will carry on, and now the defensive unit out there, Ryan Applin, trying to go up top, intended for McKissick, out of bounds, incomplete. Let's get an update now from Lewis Johnson.
Hey, Beth, you know, after my end of half interview with Bo Pelini, I followed him to the locker room and asked him if he had problem coming into the day, and he said, no, it seemed to be something that was sort of onset. But, you know, in my grandmother's words, he looked a little peaked and the eyes didn't look quite good, but didn't know what it was from and what the potential prognosis would be. But I can tell you, I am still scouring for Bo Pelini's sighting, and so far, nothing.
Thank you very much, Lewis. Intended for Carlos McCants could not hold on, so the rest of the coaches carry on. You ever have a situation like this, Joey, where somebody fell ill and kind of had to scramble, or is there usually a backup plan for this? As we will follow up on that after this third down play. Appen fakes left, goes right. David O'Kew, he's got some work to do trying to cut it back, and he will be held shy of that marker. Damian Stafford and Siante Evans.
I have not seen this situation, and I'm sure that the coaching staff knows who's next in line. You usually have an assistant head coach who would take over in these situations. When they're checking a guy's pulse, we would hope that it's just flu-like symptoms. You know, hopefully it's not something more serious than that.
There is an injured Husker down. That is Cameron Meredith, the senior from Huntington Beach, California, who was making his 30th consecutive start here today, a former high school teammate at Mater Dei of Matt Barkley's. Meredith getting some attention. Is there a chain of command like a government? Do you go to the offensive coordinator, the defensive coordinator? Is there some other assistant that steps in at that point?
I think it just depends on the coaching staff themselves. They know who the next in line is, and sometimes players don't know that. I mean, you have a feel for who would take over this you play game, so you know who the pecking order is, I guess you would say, as far as the coaches are concerned.
You've got Tim Beck, the offensive coordinator, upstairs. John Papuchis, the defensive coordinator, downstairs. Barney Cotton is listed as an associate head coach. Also handles the offensive line. He does not have a headset on the sideline. The punt is away. Abdullah will let it bounce. And it hit the sideline around the 12-yard line. 28-3, Nebraska with the lead over Arkansas State early in this second half.
Stadium in Lincoln, Nebraska. 10:44 to go in the third, and the Huskers leading Arkansas State 28-3. As the Husker offense heads back out onto the field, Beth Moens, Joey Galloway, Lewis Johnson, and Tyler Martinez ready to go on first and 10. A couple of touchdown passes today for Martinez. Amir Abdullah with a couple of touchdown runs. And he has now just gone over 100 yards rushing on the day. And the other news here in Lincoln, Bo Pelini told our Lewis Johnson at halftime that he was feeling under the weather, and he has not yet returned to the field for the Huskers in his fifth year as the head coach. Out of the eye, play action, Martinez, ball knocked loose. Still on the turf, into the end zone, and diving on it for the touchdown is Kashawn Lee. The defense forces the turnover. Shavarius Jackson able to knock it loose, and then Lee jumps on it.
If Arkansas State has any chance whatsoever getting back in this game, they have got to have plays like these that put on offense.
Coming in with the high-powered offense, and ironically enough, it's the defense that gets the first touchdown for Arkansas State. It's 28-10. Let's check in now with Lewis.
All right, Beth, well, here's another update on this Bo Pelini situation. I've had more than three witnesses tell me that they saw Pelini leave the stadium in an ambulance. We mentioned earlier that he was not feeling very good at the end of the first half. It's also been told to me that a local Channel 7 reporter has broken the news on their air that Pelini also left the stadium in an ambulance. We're not sure of his condition. I was told he was on a stretcher. He didn't look to be anything grave to me when I talked to him at the end of the half as he left the field, but not feeling good. But again, multiple witnesses, not university related, who are saying that Pelini has left the stadium and has gone to the hospital. And I'll continue to further get some further details on that.
Thank you very much, Lewis. He told Lewis Johnson as he was coming off the field at halftime that he was not feeling well, did not come back out onto the field with the team to start this third quarter. We had a 28-10 lead for Nebraska over Arkansas State. You've got your offensive coordinator up in the press box. And Tim Beck, your defensive coordinator, John Papuchis, is down on the field. You've also got Barney Cotton, who is listed as their associate head coach. We have not seen him, though, on the sideline with a headset on. So a very unique situation where the head coach unable to come back out with the team for the second half. What are you seeing right now from the Huskers about the dealing with this?
We're going to find out about their leadership in this game. Coaches talked about how much their leaders have been, and they didn't just talk about Martinez. They talked about other guys like Rex Burkhead, who isn't playing today, but he's there. They talked about Abdullah. So we're going to see what kind of leadership they have with their head guy out. You still have to focus and play football.
First and 10 from the 25, Abdullah. Doing a terrific job breaking tackles. Amir Abdullah down the sideline. And a run out of bounds at the 30. Josh Mitchell saving the touchdown as Abdullah goes 45 yards.
Beth, here's the power run game. Long pulls around, gets a block on Harold, the linebacker, and again, missed tackles is killing the Arkansas State defense. They have guys that get shots at tackling these guys, but they're not bringing them down.
Abdullah will take a breather. Amani Cross gets the carry, but Amir Abdullah got the start last week with Rex Burkhead out with the injury, and he gets another start today. They hope to have Burkhead back next week, but Amir Abdullah, 24 carries, 150 yards. He had 119 last week, a career high, and now he has broken that here this afternoon. The sophomore out of Homewood, Alabama. Of course, things also opened up for Amir in the offseason when one of their top recruits from a few years ago, Aaron Green, decided to transfer.
quick hitter to Ben Cotton, the senior tight end. One of three Cotton brothers on this Nebraska team. There is Burkhead. They hope that he'll be able to put some pads under that jersey for Idaho State next Saturday.
He has to be pretty excited watching this offensive line, you know, get going the way they were. They didn't play well last week for UCLA. So if you're Burkhead, you're sitting on the sideline, you're watching this offensive line starting to churn it up, you get excited about next week when he gets a chance to run behind him.
On first down, Hurd is offset. Just very good get that off before the play caught. The pass is low and the completion to Tariq Allen. Let's take a look at our Saturday menu brought to you by Applebee's. And what is particularly enticing about that menu, Joe?
I really like the Notre Dame-Michigan State game. Notre Dame, again, is Tarmi Rees going to start? Is he going to come off the bench? You know, what are they going to do? And in Michigan State, their defense has been outstanding.
That has been a terrific rivalry in the last decade or so. A lot of close games. Martinez off the fake. Going to dump it off underneath. Jake Long has that.
The body language for Arkansas State's defense is not good right now. You can see a number of guys have their hands on their hips in between plays. You know, they look tired, they look beat down. I think the power of the Nebraska offense and this offensive line is really starting to wear them down.
Fourth down, Martinez takes a hit, and the ball is loose, and another turnover forced by the Arkansas State defense. And what appeared to be some confusion between Martinez and Hurd. Nathan Harold forcing the fumble.
There's Harold back on the field. Harold's important to this defense. Back on the field makes a big play.
Hurd may have been the guy to jar it loose. And another break for the Red Wolves.
ESPN College Football. Brought to you by Volvo, Scandinavian luxury designed around you. And the Home Depot, more saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot.
Now the legendary Tom Osborne, three national championships. Spent some time working for the government back here in Lincoln with the University of Nebraska. One of the all-time greats in college football history. Now Ryan Appen off of the second turnover of this third quarter, trying to get another score. The defense has a touchdown with a fumble recovery in the end zone. And things have turned towards Arkansas State. Bo Pelini, feeling under the weather in the first half, is not back out here with the team in the second half. And here's the first play, Joey. And the turnover for the score.
We talked at half how everything had gone Nebraska's way in that first half. Now come out early in the third quarter and have two turnovers. We're going to see if they can get back on track.
And Husker fans know that they played okay in the first half last week against UCLA offensively and could not get things going in the second half. Just a couple of field goals. And a chance for Arkansas State now to sneak back in it.
And because Arkansas State plays this fast-paced offense, they're always in like a two-minute mode, so they have a chance to put points on the board in a hurry.
5 for 10 on third down situations in that first half. Anderson gets a chest and he's got him at the 30. A couple yards shy of the first down.
Anderson's one of those guys that they talked about. They want to get more speed guys on the field. So they take out linebacker Alonzo Whaley and they bring in Zaire Anderson, a guy who is faster, can make these kind of plays, get out wide and make a tackle. Big stop on third down. Defense gets off the field. That will stop the momentum that Arkansas State was starting to build with their second turnover.
Neely Sullivan. Round to punt it away. Now Abdullah back at the 30. A couple of special teams miscues resulted in touchdowns for Memphis last week against Arkansas State. Abdullah's going to fair catch it, drifting back at the 20-yard line. Just barely was able to get out of the way. And the officials signaling towards
the Arkansas State end zone. The officials now getting together to talk about whether Abdullah touched that football. The official on the left signaling it was Arkansas State ball. The other official signaling that it was Nebraska football. After the 54-yard punt, Abdullah signaling for the fair catch, but then inexplicably
ruling on the field is the ball touched the receiver's foot. Kicking team recovered. First down.
Arkansas State will get it back. Clipped his heel, according to the official. They're going to review it.
The ruling on the field is that the ball touched the receiver's foot and the kicking team recovered.
And that's a heck of a call. I'll be honest, when I watched this play, I thought it wasn't even close. And then when you see the replay, the other angle, it looks like it does actually clip his heel. That is a heck of a call by that official.
Now, boy, it didn't look now from that angle that it got his foot, but does it get the arm right there? Abdullah appeared to lose it in the sun. You can see he's talking to the coaches. Some of his teammates are looking up at the sky trying to shield the sun. That he looked like he was all set to make the catch, and then he lost it.
I think it's going to be Arkansas State ball here.
Well, judging from the shadow of the football and seeing the pieces of tire pop up off of the turf.
Right there, to me, looks like it catches his heel.
Yep, that angle does.
And that's, if you're up in the booth, you can't read shadows. You know, you can't look and say, well, the shadow. You've got to have definitive proof to overturn this call. And the fact that they called that a fumble, it is going to be extremely tough for someone to justify overturning that call.
Indisputable video evidence is needed to overturn this
ruling. After further review, the play stands as called on the field. First down, Arkansas State.
How about a Gus Malzahn team? Offense struggling, cannot get anything going offensively, and now we're surviving on defense and turnovers.
And now the crowd is going to stir up the black shirts. And the Nebraska defense, much maligned all week long after the UCLA loss. Not much tough to defend. First and 10, Arkansas State. Swing pass, taken down to the 15, no gain. Siante Evans coming up from the secondary.
Arkansas State seems to be missing one guy in the huddle. Again, this is when the crowd plays its part in the game. This is when that 12th man gets involved. It creates confusion. Happens in the huddle. Counting guys. No one knows who's missing.
That's their first timeout of the second half.
You could see Ryan Applin counting guys in the huddle. And then turning to the sidelines and said, hey, we need one more.
Counted three times. He counted 10 guys three times.
We're going to take a timeout. Arkansas State trying to capitalize on a third Nebraska turnover in the last 5 minutes. The Sun Belt Conference Student Athlete of the Year doing a little bit of math in the huddle, counting them up. And including himself, he says, hey, coach, we need one more out here. The defensive coordinator is trying to make it louder in Lincoln without Bo Pelini on the sideline right now with flu-like symptoms. And the pass into the end zone incomplete after the turnover. Arkansas State has it at the 15-yard line and now staring at a third and 10.
How about Nebraska's defense dealing with the confusion? Gus Malzahn is really starting to dial up these looks. He spread out number 67, who's an offensive tackle, spread him out wide, and he actually faked like he was going to catch a pass. The play didn't work because Nebraska was ready, and they have settled down and played pretty good defense in this second half.
And Nebraska now is the one that has some confusion issues. They will call the timeout. John Papuchis, who may actually be the guy in charge right now on the sideline for Nebraska without Bo Pelini. And you can see, you know, he's been taking it on the chin this week after the tough loss to UCLA, and he is showing a lot of emotion right now for this Husker defensive unit.
And that's the second time in this game they've had to burn a timeout on defense because of the confusion. Now, up until that play, it had appeared that they had a pretty good handle on what was going on offensively. Then all of a sudden, like I said, Malzahn dials up some different looks and different motions, and it creates that panic. Let's burn a timeout here. This is too big of a time in this game to allow a mistake to happen.
Reminder, we've got a terrific doubleheader coming up tonight. It's Florida, Tennessee at 6, Texas Ole Miss at 9:15 on ESPN and the Watch ESPN app. 3rd and 10. Applin fires and overthrows Josh Jarboe. They have gone for it on 4th down once already today. And it looks like they're going to opt to try and pick up the points. Brian Davis, the kicker, heading out.
That's a win for Nebraska's defense. To turn the ball over this deep in their territory, to hold them to what could be just 3 points, is a definite win for the Nebraska defense.
32-yard attempt for Davis. He was already hit from 31. And that one's good. Off of the turnover, they pick up 3 points, but judging by the look of John Papoupas, he considers that a victory as well. That is the scene from the first half, taking the pulse of Bo Pelini, who told our Lewis Johnson at halftime that he has not been feeling well this morning. So the rest of the staff, they've got his back here in the second half, despite the fact that they have turned it over 3 times here in this third quarter.
For guys like Bo Pelini, I can imagine it'd be tougher to sit somewhere inside and watch this game and not be a part of what's going on out here, because he wants to be here for his team, not a personal thing, but wants to be there for his team to lead his team through these kind of situations.
Our Lewis Johnson has been doing a terrific job down on the field. We have been trying on more than one occasion, as you can imagine, to get some information from the Nebraska Sports Information Department, and we are working diligently to try and get updates for you on Bo Pelini's condition. Here we go, taking a kickoff out across the 40. Now with 4:12 to go here in the third quarter, Nebraska's offense will head back out onto the field. And our Lewis Johnson is actually, since his repeated efforts to try and get more information have not been responded to, Lewis is actually going to try and get to the hospital himself and get some information for us, and hopefully we'll be able to pass that on to you as it comes to us from Nebraska or from Lewis. And a penalty flag on that rush from Amir Abdullah.
Offside. Defense, number 54. 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Let's check in right now with Wendy Nix.
Beth, thank you. On ESPNU, Virginia Tech trailing pit 21-3, but Kyshawn Jarrett turns up with the 94-yard punt return. It's the Hokies' first punt return for a touchdown since last season's opener. It's a 28-16 ball game.
Thank you, Wendy. Back here in Lincoln, Tim Starson with the tackle of Amir Abdullah. Abdullah's got a couple of rushing touchdowns, 25 carries, 152 yards for the second week in a row. Abdullah has new career highs, replacing the injured Rex Burkhead. Well, when Rex comes back, what they expect will be next week, they're going to have quite a 1-2 combo at tailback. Martinez going to keep it at the last minute. He pulled it away. Tim Starson was bringing the pressure. The fans thought this should have been another horse collar penalty.
Let's take a look at this.
No,
I don't think
jersey.
So. He grabbed me by the back of the jersey. That play is completely legal and a big stop. That is a, except Nebraska. Okay, I'm sorry. That was second down. So this is third and short, and this is Arkansas State's chance to get off the field.
Last two possessions have resulted in turnovers for Nebraska. A couple of fumbles. Third and three, Martinez has Bell. Forward progress should be enough to the 46-yard line. And a first down, Nebraska. Don Jones had the coverage.
It's a nice throw by Martinez. Throws the out to the wide side of the field, which is tough to do to throw out that far because the ball is in the air for so long. Kenny Bell is his big play guy who has the long touchdown today, but he's shown his ability. He can run the short route and get the short game.
Couple of receivers to the short side, a lot of room to the near side. Abdullah goes left. Pick up a couple. Sterling Young up from the secondary to join in with Nathan Harold on the tackle.
That's what Arkansas State's going to have to do, bring more than one guy to the tackle. It's going to take two or three guys because their tackling has been so bad. The way to solve it, bring two to three guys on each tackle.
Second down. Martinez keeps. And we should have enough for the first down to the 35. Now, Lewis Johnson reported earlier in the game that he had reports that Bo Pelini left on a stretcher in an ambulance to go to a local hospital. The Associated Press is now reporting, and ESPN.com is also reporting that Pelini has left the stadium to go to a local hospital. Reporting that he was not feeling well earlier in the day, and Lewis is now on his way to try and get an update from the hospital here in Lincoln as Martinez runs out of bounds at the 24-yard line and another first down.
This is really good decision-making by Martinez. Stood in the pocket, looked around, no one's open, all his receivers were covered, tucks the ball and runs it. And that's what you get from Martinez. His decision-making has improved, his throwing has improved, and his command of this offense and command of the game is definitely better than it was last season in the first two games.
Well, this looks a lot like the last drive, Joey, where they moved it well into the red zone and then coughed it up. Let's see if they are a little bit more settled. Trying to adjust to not having the coach on the sideline. Third inside the 20. And what do you think, Joey, about the leadership and the adjustments now? Pelini's been gone for almost the entire quarter.
I think they've done a really good job besides the turnovers. I mean, they've been able to move the ball on offense. They've driven down on long drives. And I think that this team has done a good job showing their leadership on the field. And I think the coaches also are to be commended because they have kept this team together and they've done what they've needed to do to play winning football. Defense just gets a huge stop after a turnover. So that's what they're going to need to do to keep their foot on top of Arkansas State.
Something that you may or may not spend a whole lot of time preparing for. The head coach not on the sideline. Feeling under the weather in the first half here today. But Tom Papuchis trying to get the sea of red to make some waves with a 28-13 lead.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
Back here at the University of Nebraska in Lincoln, Arkansas State with 10 points in the third quarter to get back in it. Nebraska now on the move. This is the eighth play of a drive that started on their own 43. They've turned it over three times in this second half as they continue to play without head coach Bo Pelini on the sideline. And Abdullah with the carry. Amir Abdullah, career highs in carries and rushing yardage today. Taylor Martinez has thrown a couple of TD passes to Kenny Bell. And Abdullah's got the first down again. John Papuchis, the defensive coordinator, is down on the sideline. And up in the press box, Tim Beck, the offensive coordinator. Papuchis has been on the staff for 5 years, but this is his first year as the defensive coordinator. In terms of who might be running the show on the sideline right now. Abdullah gets inside the 10. Good second effort to get to about the 7.
It's another missed tackle for Arkansas State, which has been their Achilles heel today, you know, with a chance to make a play in the backfield, which is what your team needs at this point. Abdullah was able to make the defender miss in the backfield and gain positive yards.
And sweep Abdullah off the right side. Ooh, he took a good lick right at the line of scrimmage to bounce him back. Gonna set up third down.
If there had been a question about Abdullah, it would be whether he could run between the tackles. You know, Burkhead is a bigger guy, you know, 220 or so, and Abdullah 195, and they said that he could run between the tackles, and he has shown that today, that he can take a hit and keep going and break a few tackles.
Third and goal for Martinez. Allen and Turner come to the near side. Bell up top. Looking left all the way and incomplete. Intended for Jones and a flag down in the end zone.
Arkansas State brings the pressure off of both sides, and Martinez takes a pretty good hit here.
Pass
and
interference.
The ball.
Defense, number 24. Penalty occurred in the end zone. By rule, the ball is placed at the 2-yard line. Automatic first down.
Watch the pressure come off of both edges as Jones is gets another hit on Martinez. One guy high, one guy low. Hopefully Martinez is okay, but that's what they wanted to do, was pressure Martinez and get the ball out of his hands. Unfortunately for Arkansas State, it's an interference in the end zone.
That was whistled on Andrew Tryon. And right up the middle, and a touchdown run for Imani Crow from 2 yards out. Rushing touchdown of his Nebraska career for Imani Cross at a 34-13 lead. Maher adds to it. 35-13, Nebraska early in this fourth quarter. Be a doozy tonight, and one of the many this evening to choose from. You're going to need two or three televisions in the same room. Starting at 6 o'clock, games for you at 7, 8, 9, 15, and 10 o'clock Eastern tonight, concluding with the Holy War, BYU and Utah, and right smack dab in the middle there is that Notre Dame Michigan State contest. So big for the Irish and the Spartans. 35-13 the score here, and the other story that we're following is the health of coach Bo Pelini, and the Nebraska coach at halftime speaking to our Lewis Johnson.
Well, first of all, we saw someone taking your pulse late in this half. Are you okay?
I'm okay. I'm fine. I'm all right. Not feeling real good.
they were checking his pulse over on the sideline. Right after he spoke to Lewis, there he is trotting off to the locker room, and he did not return with the team to come out for the start of the third quarter. After the short game, Lewis reporting that he was taken via ambulance to a local hospital. Those reports being confirmed by other local outlets. We sent our spotter Mark Williams down the hallway. Thanks to Greg Sharp, Matt Davison, Lane Grindle, and the Husker Sports Network. The radio guys sharing with us that Papuchis, the defensive coordinator, is now the acting coach on the sideline. And first down yardage and more for Arkansas State out to the 45-yard line on the carry by Rocky Hayes. And there is the Husker Sports Network, the local guys helping us out there. Information has not been very forthcoming. The Nebraska Sports Information Department wanting to hold on to that information, apparently, and not share too much about Coach Pelini. And our Lewis Johnson, after that halftime report, went to the local hospital himself to see if he can get any more information for us. Stuffed Pat Randall along with Baker Steinbrenner and part of that defensive front. Papuchis and the Nebraska fans liking this score much more than last week. You can't really say enough about how disappointed the players and coaches were, and really a malaise that fell over the program on Sunday before they quickly bounced back Monday and immediately got back to work.
And I'm sure they'll be very excited, you know, to sit down and watch this film and see what they've done, because their adjustments were so good. They started off early with this offense, and they looked a little confused those first two drives, and then they settled down, and you can see they've played with a lot more confidence, and it seems like they know what they're doing. There isn't the missed assignments that we've seen a lot of last week.
Third down and 11. Knighton taking the snap, gets to midfield, and that will be about 4 yards short. Will Compton with the tackle.
Interesting call. Third and 11, down 22 with 11 minutes left in this game, and Alpin is out of the game. I mean, he is your guy, and he's on the sideline. That is an interesting call.
Now Applin will come back on, and they will go for it again on fourth down.
Eric Martin just comes off the edge. He gets a clean shot at Applin, gets the ball loose. These are the kind of plays defensively that you have come to expect over the years from this Nebraska defense.
The youngest defensive coordinator in FBS is all fired up for the black shirt defense. Just 34 years of age, taking over for Bo's brother Carl this year, who became the head coach at Florida Atlantic. From Braylon Hurd, busting into the secondary. First down, Huskers.
The missed tackles again, and we've seen this time and time again today. They have the stop, and they allow him to break out of the tackle. Now, this is Hurd. This is the faster running back, you know, and he's breaking tackles. Arkansas State will have to go home and work on their tackling.
14 yards on that game. Hurd again. Nice stutter step up the middle. Picks up eight more.
The ball carrier.
Bo Pelini talked to us yesterday. One of his messages was about perspective. Yeah, it was a hard loss for us to accept last week, but we're not going to get crazy. We're not. Saturday's result doesn't change what we do on Monday morning, was the way he put it. And expecting all of his players and coaches to be able to rebound and respond. And now with the coach's health in question here in the second half, certainly even more perspective for the Nebraska team as well as Husker Nation.
The problems they had versus UCLA needed to be fixed whether they won or lost. They only lost by 6 points, and they had a chance to win that game. And what he's saying is, even if we won, we would have looked at that film and been very disappointed in the way we played.
Martinez keeps. Now back in front of him. Zimmer able to score.
Speed. Here's Martinez with his feet. When he turns it on, you can see him split the defenders and then take two guys into the end zone with him. And that's why he's a difference maker in this game. He can do everything, and he has thrown well today and ran well.
...41-13 on his 22nd birthday today, the dual threat quarterback. A couple of touchdown passes, and now a touchdown run. Give number three on the day. Let's take a look at today's hardest working coach, brought to you by Polaris. And it's the defensive coordinator and now acting head coach for Nebraska, John Papuchis. And how about the effort from the coach?
Not great athleticism on the jump, but yeah, his excitement has got to be the way his defense has played today. This is his moment to shine. He has got to do something to get on ESPN.
He's been spending more time on the field than on the sideline. The linesman over there doesn't even have to remind him anymore. He knows to run back to the white stripe. And it's been a rough week, especially on the defensive side for Nebraska. And coming back strong today, they will have Idaho State next week. They hope to have Rex Burkhead back next week. And then the end of September, they have a rough five-game stretch to open up the Big Ten Conference that starts with Wisconsin. Well, after an exciting finish at Richmond that resulted in Jeff Gordon getting into the chase, it's officially underway, the postseason, the Geico 400 in Chicago tomorrow at 1 o'clock Eastern on ESPN. NASCAR Countdown presented by Tire Rack will get things started.
Look for Matt Kenseth, his last year with Ford, and he's moving on. So look for Matt Kenseth to have a good run in that number 17 Ford, Beth.
Look at you dropping the chassis and dropping the top down on a little NASCAR knowledge. Beth Mullins, Joey Galloway, Lewis Johnson with you today in Lincoln.
Arkansas State eventually is going to have to go downfield. I mean, at this stage of game, there's, you know, less than 9 minutes left in the game. You're going to have to get big chunks of yards here eventually.
Then gives it to Oku. He's got the first down. Wrapped up at the 41. Let's check in with Wendy Nix.
Beth, thank you very much. Ohio State and Cal, this game on ABC. Brandon Bigelow gets loose and is good for a career-long 81-yard touchdown. The score now 20-14.
Cal hanging around with the Buckeyes today in Columbus. It's a big weekend for the Big Ten, trying to bounce back. Went 6-for-6 last week. I think all 12 teams are at home this week. The big one coming up later tonight on ABC, Michigan State hosting Notre Dame.
That's three straight runs from Arkansas State. I mean, I'm not real sure what Coach Malzahn is doing here. Maybe he's somewhat waving the white flag, but three straight runs, 42-13, less than 8 minutes left in the fourth. This is interesting play calling.
Third down, and one. They've got to get inside the 49 of Nebraska. Upland will hand it off again. Oku's got the first down inside the 45.
Even with that being, I mean, even with the first down, if you're Papuchis, if you're Nebraska, you're happy with this play calling. You will take this. That's the fourth straight run. So you're okay with this game. It keeps the clock running, which the clock is your best friend right now.
Okay, Justin Malzahn on the sideline. Throwing it out to McKissick. Oh, nice spin to get away from Stafford. Inside the 30-yard line. Damian caught him from behind at the 28.
That's a time when Stafford's speed was a problem for him. He came up way too fast. You got to settle your feet. I mean, that ball is caught behind the line of scrimmage. Settle your feet. You got a lot of field, a lot of room to work with, and let the rest of the defense come and rally and help you.
Seven catches, 74 yards today for McKissick. As Francis Johnson pulls his way to the 25 as the clock continues to run. Here in Lincoln, Nebraska today, the Cornhuskers leading Arkansas State 42-13. Taylor Martinez, a couple of passing touchdowns, a rushing touchdown, and career highs for Amir Abdullah, who has scored twice, a mere 30 carries for 167 yards. They have played this second half without head coach Bo Pelini on the sideline.
Illegal substitution. Defense number 96, the 12th man on the field. 5-yard penalty, replay second down.
During the halftime interview, Lewis Johnson questioning Bo Pelini, who said he was not feeling well this morning. He did not come back out with the team for the second half. And as Lewis Johnson reported, taken by ambulance to a local hospital. Lewis went to the hospital himself to try and get some more information that has not been forthcoming. It was caught by Smith at the 23.
Both safeties for Nebraska have really shown up today. Stafford, number 3, Smith, number 13, have made a number of open field tackles where they've had to use their speed to go run a guy down and make a tackle. And again, now it's 3rd and 4 for Arkansas State's offense. And, Beth, I would expect to see a pass here eventually. Yeah. And it is strange to me what's going on.
Third down and 4.
I could be wrong.
On the toss, and it looks like it's a yard short. And a flag is down as well.
Chop block, offense number 60. 15-yard penalty, replay third down.
Beth, I was wrong last time. I expected to see a pass. Now, at 3rd and 19,
I would concur.
Is there a good chance I could be right if I call for a pass play at 3rd and 19?
You're playing. The odds are in your favor for sure.
All right, I feel good. And let's see a pass here.
But as you alluded to earlier, at what point, if you're Arkansas State, you say, okay, we want to work on some stuff that might be helping us in the future in Sun Belt play, as opposed to trying to make this comeback in the fourth quarter. They don't go downfield with it. They try and set up the receiver screen to Julian Jones. Zaire Anderson bringing some pressure that time.
Now, Taylor Stockamer is not here, who was their leading receiver last season. He's not here today. And maybe that affects the play calling of going downfield. So, you know, you start to wonder, okay, what is the coaching staff thinking? Why will they not go downfield? There has got to be some reason.
Another fourth down try for Arkansas State. And that one will go ahead and pooch punt it. And it will settle at the 17-yard line with Nebraska in control at home in Lincoln.
ESPN College Football is presented by 5-Hour Energy. Hours and hours of energy. And in part by your local Scion dealer.
let's take a little trip down memory lane and the Roller Skating Museum, which is also the home of USA Roller Sports here in Lincoln, Nebraska. Got some inline, got a chainsaw roller skates going on. One of the things to see while you're here in town for a Nebraska football game. Huskers have been pretty good offensively. Taylor Martinez, apparently his day is done. A couple of touchdown passes, a touchdown run. Able to celebrate his birthday with a victory. As you're watching college football on ESPN, presented by 5-Hour Energy. Martinez was close to perfect, 13 for 14, 180 yards in the air, 54 yards rushing. And now Ron Kellogg III is on as quarterback. Let's send it back to Wendy Nix.
Beth, thank you. We go back to Columbus where Cal was hanging around, but now the Bears have taken the lead. Zach Maynard with the quarterback keeper. It's 21-20 over on ABC, the fourth quarter underway. 10 minutes, 20 seconds left to play in this ballgame.
Thank you, Wendy. And a big gain on a terrific cut by Imani Cross. To the 30-yard line. Run out of bounds by Kyle Coleman, a 46-yard pickup.
Yeah, I think the defense is just completely spent now. I mean, another missed tackle, but the initial hole through the defensive line, Beth, me and you could have run through there. And I think they're just worn down. I think it's been a long day. This offensive line from Nebraska is just pounding on them, and you can see it now, fewer guys getting a chance at the ball carrier.
On the pitch fade. It's going to be real interesting to see, Joey, once the playoff format comes into play in a couple of years, the future of games like this, where you've got the power conference school playing against the mid-major, so to speak. It's obviously a wonderful payday that helps the entire athletic department at Arkansas State. They also got close to $1 million to go play at Oregon earlier this year. And it gives a team like Nebraska another home date. That obviously helps them in the pocketbook as well.
These teams like Arkansas State, they're trying to put $22 million into their facilities this year. They go get a Gus Malzahn from Auburn, to come be your head coach. All these things cost money. And from a budget standpoint, they need that $1 million from Nebraska. It's not Arkansas State saying, we want to send our kids into these games and see if we can overtake Nebraska at all times. Your budget makes those decisions for out-of-conference schools, such as the Sun Belt schools.
Third and short cross. To the 20, may have needed a little bit more. We'll see where the spot is. Colin Cowherd was talking about this yesterday on his radio program, about whether or not Nebraska should be playing this game or Arkansas State should be playing this game. Certainly, I think they're going to have to work in some sort of strength of schedule or somewhere down the line go to, the teams that get into the playoffs are conference champions. So we saw Michigan punished in the polls for taking on Alabama, for example, earlier this year.
Absolutely. Michigan went from number 8 and fell to number 19 because they lost to Alabama, who everyone, says is the number one team in the country. Now, if you're Michigan coming into next season, you have a chance to schedule Arkansas State, or you have a chance to schedule Alabama, what are you going to do? I mean, if you're going to punish me 11 spots in the poll, and at the end of the season, that's what matters is can I get into that playoff, then why even take the chance?
But isn't it better for recruiting, Joey, as a player coming out of high school, wouldn't you rather go somewhere where you're going to be playing against the big-time programs on national college or national television early in the season?
I think you would rather go to a school that has a chance to win a national championship. And if we've got a fight from number 19 now for Michigan, it's going to be tough to get into that national championship game from there. So, to me, I think that, number one, the punishment for losing to an Alabama should not be so great. You know,
but
it should be 11 spots.
But if you win the Big Ten, that's not a punishment. But that would be the big if.
But that, and then again, that is the big if. You know, these games, it gives Nebraska another home game, like you said, which brings their fans. So they're going to put 85,000 into this stadium, no matter who shows up, whether it's Michigan, Penn State, Michigan State, or whether it's Arkansas State.
And there's another turnover in the red zone, and Arkansas State heading the other direction with it. Nebraska gives it away inside the 10-yard line. Their fourth turnover of this second half. But otherwise, what's been a positive day on the scoreboard in a 42-13 lead. Welcome back to Lincoln, and a happy birthday for Taylor Martinez, a 42-13 lead. Final seconds about to tick away. After the turnover, Arkansas State has it right back. They will drop to 1-2 on the season, Nebraska to 2-1. As the Huskers have played this second half without head coach Bo Pelini, who was not feeling well and was taken to a local hospital. A record-setting day for Amir Abdullah. New career highs for Amir today, 30 carries, 167 yards. And Martinez linked up with Kenny Bell twice for long touchdowns today. 42-13. The final score. Let's send it down now to Lewis Johnson, who has returned from the hospital.
Yeah, Beth, with about 4 minutes to go in the third quarter, I left the stadium to go see if I could find where Bo Pelini was located. There are three hospitals within the area, and I went to all three. First to Brian LG West Hospital, not there, then to East, and I just a moment ago arrived from visiting St. Elizabeth's Hospital. Didn't see any form of university personnel there to say that he was actually at the hospital, so it's still a mystery. But Bo Pelini somehow slipped away from the stadium, and they're looking after him somewhere. We're just not sure, but now the story seems to be that Pucis was able to keep this team intact and get them a victory here today. Beth?
Thank you very much, Lewis, for all your efforts. And certainly our best wishes out to Coach Bo Pelini that he is feeling better and that it is nothing serious. The Huskers, well, they turned it over several times in the second half, but they were still able to get enough generated for the 42-13 lead, and obviously a much better showing on the defensive side of the ball today, Joey, than last week against UCLA.
Definitely a better showing, and Coach Papuchis and this Nebraska team has got to be excited about what they did defensively. Now, this coaching staff will go nuts about these four turnovers, Beth.
Lewis has the defensive coordinator right now, John Papuchis.
All right, Beth, thanks a lot. Well, first of all, have you ever been in a situation where your head coach disappears and all of a sudden you have the reins?
No. But, you know, Bo's the true leader of this football team. Told him, don't worry, we're going to be fine. And our guys responded well.
What was it like at halftime when apparently he left here with some sort of medical situation and I guess you found out that you had to take the reins?
Calm in the locker room. Our guys are a mature group. They did a great job, handled it well. They knew that they wanted to come out and play the best half of football they could play for him, and I thought they did a good job.
You know, when we talked with you earlier in the week, you were concerned about defense. You hadn't played well in that first game. But how about the bounce back here when you came and held Arkansas State to 3 points in the first half?
Really proud of the way our guys responded. The theme of the week has been overcoming adversity. We had some adversity, you know, obviously last week, but it had some today. You know, obviously with Bo and with the turnovers early in the second half, I thought our defense responded extremely well. I was proud of everyone. It was a good team win.
So the Sea of Red will appreciate a victory here. This is the first of a three-game homestand. So what will be the message in the locker room about how to handle adversity, as you mentioned, where you lose the head coach, you come back and bounce back with great defense, and now you continue on with the season?
You know, when you play football, when you play sports, it teaches a great life lessons. When you get knocked down, you got to get up. And the people who are successful in life, they respond that way. And
all right. All right. Congratulations on the win.
Appreciate it.
Beth?
Thank you very much, Lewis. From over 600 yards allowed to UCLA last week, they hold Arkansas State to 286 total yards today and hold them to 13 points on the scoreboard. Amir Abdullah, career highs rushing today, and Taylor Martinez responsible for three touchdowns as Nebraska does indeed overcome adversity to get the win. The final score, 42-13. Nebraska a winner over Arkansas State. They improved to 2-1 on the season. The Red Wolves at 1-2. And now let's send you back to the studio.
Football scoreboard.